So here are some of the stuff that we're going to use. So for the interior microfiber cloths, I really recommend brushes. Like some kind of brushes at least. This car has leather seats, leather brush. One of these plastic brushes that's really effective to getting dog hair and cat hair and that stuff out. Interior cleaner and a multi-purpose cleaner. First we remove the floor mats in the car. For the first step, while vacuuming the car, I use this rubber brush, dog hair and so on, get it out. Also a smaller detailing brush to get in all the vents, door sides and so on, to get all the dust away. We have put some tape over the vacuums, whatever you call it, so it doesn't scratch up panels. Really recommend to do this. Pencil brush, detailing brush, and the leather brush. Try to get as much as you can off during this stage. Now we're going to use an inside cleaner. Start off by spraying, and then you rub it in. Big difference when you use some kind of liquid to get all the other dirt up. This basically feels all brand new again. Same applies to the seats. This is suited for leather. Don't let this one dry into the leather. You need to wipe it off with M-fiber cloth when you have gotten it all smooshed in, with preferably a cleaning brush. But you can actually use microfiber as well, just to rub it in with. But I like the pencils. I actually did some research just before this. I've never done this personally, but if you have the vented seats that have like these holes in the leather, it works just as fine. It's not going to break your stuff, even if it gets a little bit wet. Now we just rub it in everywhere. And wipe off everything. I usually prefer to not use as much of the cleaner when I get closer to speakers and so on. Just use a little bit more gently amount of product. You can roll the window down if you feel a bit insecure. You don't want API necessarily on your window, so you can just get it down if you feel uncertain. Spraying interior cleaner into the brush, and I'll start brushing off all of the steering wheel. In leather you probably want to rub, so you get everything out of the leather. You can actually feel how the steering wheel gets way more sticky now, before it was really glance and so on. So this is all the fat, body fluids, whatever that gets stuck in here while you're driving, that's getting off. Here we got some old skin fall off, dirt. It's preferable to have big focus on the instruments that you use the most, and start stop button is the prime example, so as the steering wheel. This category we also include the dash with all the buttons. Just API clean the whole dash. Make sure you get all the buttons soaked in real nice in the cleaning. One thing with interior cleaning, people sometimes have problems with, is getting the air vents real clean and nice. And that's when you really need the interior brush to get in between the vents real deep. Now for a part that many people skip, the seat belts. Microfiber cloth and just swipe seat belts all the way with a microfiber cloth. All fresh and nice. Now we're finished with the front side of the car and we'll move into the back seat. So the back seat is a bit more dirtier. You can actually see the ISOFIXes have been used by the previous owner, which basically means there has been kids in the back seat. So you can see all kinds of stains, more stains on the seats and so on. Soda in the cup holders, you can see the stains. All this we're going to get off. Can actually see the all the stains. Looks like soda to me. Soda and chocolate mix up. Also, we're going to finish up back side of the front seat. It's way easier to do from the back seat. Nice pushed up. Car is now finished and here comes the final cut.